and welcome to Welcome Road Baptist Church and the Fundamentals of Christianity. My name is Dan Odom. Thank you for joining with me today. If you're new to the channel, please consider subscribing and clicking the bell for notifications so you know when we have uploaded a new video. But thank you for stopping by and clicking on this video. And as you can tell by the title, why, God, why? I'm not going to give you the answers to that. I'm not going to give you the answers as to why for the specific trials and problems that you have. In the sense of, I can't give you, you know, the A, B's, and C's of it and explain all of it out. But what I would like to do is to give you just a couple of scripture verses so that to help you, to remind you of the overall why, to answer the overall question of why. Often in our lives, we do face some very troublesome and troubling situations. Situations that we did not necessarily volunteer for. Things that come into our lives that we as individuals, we really have no control over them. Whether it be family situations and family problems, whether it be physical ailments and discouragements. All of these things, they really and truly do begin to weigh heavy on our minds and on our hearts. Now, there's help in Scripture. There's help from God. We don't have to stay in that place. We don't have to live under the cloud of doubt, the cloud of discouragement, even the cloud of depression where we're low. We don't have to stay there. We don't have to live in those areas. God, as believers, we are encouraged to live the blessed life, the happy life, the life of joy. And God gives us joy, and He gives us love, and He gives us peace, that contentment and satisfaction that can truly and only be found in Jesus Christ. And that is what God desires for us. Often, though, what happens is that maybe we forget that. We get our eye on the actual problem of our situation and circumstance instead of on the person of our situation or circumstance. Everything that is around us, it builds and it builds and it builds. And those are very real things. Those situations, Paul, in the chapter that we're going to look at, just a couple of verses in 2 Corinthians 4, Paul describes that he's persecuted, he's pressed down, he is confused, he doesn't have the answers to problems and to the things of life. And so Paul is going through many, many issues. But then on the other side of that, he says, even though I am confused, yet I know who has the answers. And although I don't have the answers personally, he says, I know the one that does. I know the one that is in control. I know the one that is leading in my life. And so I want to give you a verse, just a real quick reminder of God's provision and God's purpose. Now, Romans chapter number 8, and we're not going to actually look at this particular verse, but I want to mention this verse first and then look at just two short and great verses. In Romans 8, verse 28 and 29, we are told that everything is working together for our good. It doesn't mean that everything that is happening is good, nor is it enjoyable. But everything that is happening, the good and the bad, is happening for our good. When we read the next verse, verse 29, we find out what that good thing is. And that good thing is to be conformed unto the image of Jesus Christ. Now, that is the will of God for your life. God wants you to look like Jesus Christ. God wants you to be as Christ is right now in this world. 1 John 4 and verse 17 tells us that. And so God desires for you to be like the Son of God now, okay? So everything that is happening to that end. Whether it be the people that you meet that God allows to come into your life, or the people that God removes from your life. It's to the end for you to be like Jesus Christ. whether it be the issues on your job, the reason is for you to be conformed into the image of Jesus Christ. Now, having said that, it doesn't, and I know there's some differences of opinion on this, and this is a, can be a deep theological problem or study to get into. That doesn't mean that everything that comes into our lives, that God is meticulously bringing it to pass, okay? That God says, okay, I am going to purposefully, you know, do this or do that. God does do that, okay? But understand, there are things that God just allows, that God knows they're going to happen, and God allows them to happen. But He didn't purposefully bring it. He allowed it to take place. But then there are times when God purposefully authors for something to come into our lives. He purposefully brings it into our lives. Whichever one, maybe God is allowing it, maybe God is the author behind it. Regardless, God is very active in both of those situations. And we see this playing out all through Scripture. Okay, when you look at the life of Peter, and when the night that Peter denied the Lord, okay, Satan wanted to sift him, and yet Christ prayed that Peter's faith wouldn't fail. Well, who was the one that brought that into the life of Peter? Well, Satan did. God allowed it, but God wasn't the author of it. But this is the point, though, is that through that situation, God was using it to transform Peter into the image and likeness of the Son of God. Now, having said that, this is a scripture I want you to look at and to consider. 2 Corinthians 4, verse 17 and verse number 18. Paul writes and he says this, "For our light affliction, which is but for a moment." Now, I know that the things that we go through, they're not light. And God Himself here, and Paul, under inspiration of the Spirit of God, is not saying and belittling what we're going through. He says our affliction is light, and it is but for a moment, because of the rest, which worketh for us a far more exceeding and eternal weight of glory. In other words, when we look at what we're going through, and we look at what God is trying to accomplish in our lives, making us look like Christ, and an eternal weight of glory that we cannot even comprehend. He says it cannot be compared. The things that we're going through now cannot even be compared with that. Verse 18, "For while we look not at the things which are seen, but at the things which are not seen. For the things which are seen are temporal, but the things which are not seen are eternal." And so what Paul says is that these things are, they're temporal. Don't look at these temporal things. Yes, they're issues, and yes, they're problems that we have to handle, and they're situations that we have to live through. But Paul says, look at those things that are eternal. Now, go back to verse 17, and kind of right there in the middle, Paul says, "Worketh for us a far more exceeding and eternal weight of glory." Now, the idea of this word "worketh" means to produce. What is happening is this, is that the light affliction, which is but for a moment, that light affliction is working or is producing in us and for us something that is far exceeding, and it's an eternal weight of glory that we can't even comprehend. So this is what Paul says. You're going through difficulty, but remember, that difficulty, God is using it to produce something in you that you will realize and that you will see when you get into glory and you get into heaven. Now, what is that that God is working in us? Well, it's Christ's likeness. It's the image of Jesus Christ Himself. Now, we don't know what we're going to be like. We don't know what we'll be, but we do know that God is producing and is changing within inside of us an image of Jesus Christ. Why, God? Why? How often have we asked that question? And God's answer and God's response is not, it is specific. It's not specific to that particular reason or that particular situation, but this is God's answer. I want you to look like Jesus, and I'm producing something in your life. Why? I don't always know. God doesn't always reveal it, the specifics. You know, what is, sometimes it leads to greater and better things. Sometimes they're hurtful. But I'm going to tell you this, God is working in our hearts. He's working in our lives to make us look like His Son, the Lord Jesus Christ. May God richly bless you as you continue your walk with the Son of God.